Dear students, now we are moving to the next part of cleavage. In the previous class, we have seen what are the different planes of cleavage, but here we are discussing the same topic, cleavage, but in a different aspect. So let's move. Here we are discussing about the cleavage with respect to the amount of yolk. In the very beginning, I have just told you what are the different types of egg, where we have discussed depending upon certain criteria, we have classified eggs into different types like the amount of yolk, the distribution of yolk, etc. So, in the amount of yolk, we have categorized different types of eggs, right? That is microlistel, mesolistel, telolistel, and mesolistel as well as macrolistel and centrolistel. So, in these kinds of different eggs, the pattern of cleavage is different because the distribution of yolk is different. So, based upon the difference in the amount of yolk, the cleavage is also getting different among different animals. So, let's move to the detail of this cleavage, which is based upon the amount of yolk. Actually, based upon the amount of yolk, the cleavage can be classified into two different types, that is complete cleavage and partial or incomplete cleavage. The complete cleavage is called holoblastic cleavage. Holoblastic cleavage in the sense that here the entire egg will undergo complete cleavage, results in the formation of blastomeres, which are either equal in size or unequal in size. Here you can see that this is a holoblastic cleavage. Here you can see that this is the zygote. The zygote first divided into two equal cells, then it divides into four cells, then it divides into eight cells. Here you can see that the division is actually complete. That means it will bisect the whole part of egg. So that type of cleavage is called a complete or holoblastic cleavage. The another one is called a meroblastic cleavage or partial cleavage. Here what actually happens is that here cleavage takes place, but here due to the availability of high amount of yolk, actually here the cleavage will take place only at the active cytoplasm. Okay, the rest of the part will be undivided. The rest of the part in the sense that most of the region which is occupied by the yolk will be undivided. So we can say that the holoblastic equal cleavage generally taking place in microlistel and isolistel type of egg, where the amount of yolk is very low and it is uniformly distributed. While the case of meroblastic cleavage, we can see that the meroblastic cleavage is generally exhibited by macrolistel and mesolistel type of egg. Here what happens is that the cleavage generally taking place only those area where the cytoplasm is found. Here we can see that this is a meroblastic cleavage. Here this is the egg. Here the cytoplasm is occupied only in this particular area and it didn't. So first it divided into two, then divided into a 4, then divided into 8, 16, etc. Here you can see that this is not completely dividing the egg. Here the cleavage generally took place only at the active part of the cytoplasm. The rest of the part remains unaffected or remains undivided. So this is called a meroblastic cleavage or partial cleavage. Then we can divide this complete cleavage or holoblastic cleavage into two different types, that is holoblastic equal and holoblastic unequal. This two cleavages are actually complete, but the difference is mainly due to the size of the blastomeres which produced. In the case of holoblastic equal cleavage, it divides again completely, but the resulting blastomeres are equal in size. Okay, so this is generally found in amphioxus, that is it exhibited by microlistel and isolistel type of egg. Here all holoblastic unequal cleavage is here the division is complete, but what actually happens is the blastomeres produced are unequal in size. Here you can see that it divides completely, and some blastomeres are generally positioned here and some blastomeres are positioned here. So those blastomeres which is generally found on the animal hemispheres are very smaller in size, while the blastomeres which is generally produced at the vegetal hemispheres are larger in size. So here unequal sized blastomeres are produced both at the animal as well as in the vegetal pore. So this type of cleavage is called a holoblastic unequal cleavage. Okay. Then comes meroblastic cleavage. Meroblastic cleavage, I told you that this is an incomplete cleavage in which the division due to the higher amount of yolk, division take place only at the active cytoplasm, but the remaining portion will be, that is the area which is occupied by the yolk, will be undivided or unaffected. So these are two different types, superficial cleavage and discoidal cleavage. Superficial cleavage is generally exhibited by macrolecithal and centrolecithal type of egg. You know that centrolecithal type of egg is generally found in insects. Here we can see that the nucleus is generally found at the center of the cytoplasm. It will divide continuously, and after the division is over, the zygote, this nucleus will move into the peripheral region. From here, from the central region, it moves into the peripheral region, and a single blastoderm will be formed at the periphery. So this type of cleavage is called the superficial cleavage. That means the here the division generally took place at the center of the nucleus, then it will undergo repeated division, and finally it moves into the peripheral region, and a blastoderm is formed at the peripheral area. This is called a superficial cleavage. This is mainly exhibited by insects. Then called the discoidal cleavage. Discoidal cleavage is generally exhibited by microlecithal and extremely telolecithal. What is mean by extremely telolecithal type of egg? Here the yolk is concentrated at the entire portion and including most of the part of the animal pore also. Okay, so this is found in heavily yolked macrolecithal type of egg of birds as well as reptiles. Here I told you, as I told you, the cytoplasm. Here the cleavage remains restricted only at the active part of the cytoplasm. The remaining portion is become undivided, and this is in the formation of blastoderm. Here in this animal pole, and the lower part will be unaffected. So this is actually a form of this blastomeres. This form is having an appearance of a disc shaped structure, and hence it is called a discoidal cleavage. Okay, so that's all about the cleavage which is generally taking place with respect to the amount of yolk. Thank you.